Good afternoon, each and everyone. Once again, I am welcoming you all in your own channel, that is RET Classes, where you are learning your physics in a better and a easier way. So in this today's lecture, we will study about the law of conservation of momentum. As we have already done about the Newton's first law, Newton's second law, as well as Newton's third law in our previous video. If you find any of the difficulty in the previous lecture, then please contact us on our email ID, that is letclasses@gmail.com, or you can share your queries on the YouTube channel also. And I feel very proud when your messages came, as well as one of you have asked for the previous year questions, also important questions for chapter wise. That definitely I will surely I will make it for you people. And today we will start with the next topic, that is the conservation of momentum. So I'm starting with that law of conservation of momentum. Okay, so what does this law of conservation say? Law of conservation क्या बताता है? Of momentum. Momentum. This I have already explained you about momentum. Momentum is denoted by p. And it is the product of mass and velocity. So also, I have explained you about this. So today we will start with the law of conservation of momentum. Like if I am having 10 trophies with me, okay. And after that 10 trophies, what we will do? After that 10 trophies, we will have the next part is I had given 5 trophies to you people, and after that, we are having 5 trophies with me and 5 trophies with you. It means both the trophies remains constant with us, 5 with me and 5 with you. So similarly, in the case of conservation of momentum, in that case, we can say ki if the bodies are interacting with each other, what I'm saying, listen to me carefully. If the bodies are interacting with each other, so their total momentum remains conserved. That means the total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. Got it? What I'm saying? That when the two bodies are interacting, suppose I'm saying that these are the two bodies. This is the first one, this is the second one. Having A and B, both are approaching, okay, both are interacting with each other. It is moving with the velocity of UB. It is moving with the initial velocity of UA. This is having the mass MA. And this is having the mass m. Okay, so if I am talking about the momentum of A body, PU, so what is the momentum now? MAU, mass into velocity. Similarly, if I am taking the example of momentum of B part, so what is the momentum? MB, UB. This is the case of before collision. And it is the case before collision. But when these two bodies collide with each other, like this, when these two bodies collide with each other, mass remains the same, MA and MB. But they are interacting with each other. That is, first body interact due to second, and second body is having the mass due to the first, that is FBA. So FAB is the force on the first due to second body, and FBA is the force on second due to first body. So it is the case of during collision, yes. Not after, just during collision. Collision ke duran jo hua, usme kya hua? Ek dusre ke upar force laga. Now after that, when the collision removes, then what happened? After that, we are having this one. They are moving with the another velocity after collision, that is VA with the final velocity, and MB, that is VB. Okay, so what is the momentum? P dash A is equal to MAUA, MAVA. Similarly, P dash B is equal to MB, VB. This is the case of after collision. This is the case of after collision. Okay. So what happened? As we know that Newton's second law states, F is proportional to the rate of change of momentum. Rate of change of momentum divided by time. This we all know. ओके कि फोर्स जो होता है वो किसके प्रोपोर्शनल होता है बेटा, रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम बाय टाइम। ओके रेट है तो इट मींस डिवाइड बाय टाइम होगा, तो इसको आप रिमूव ही कर दे तो ज्यादा बेटर है, रेट को आप ना लिखिए, बिकॉज रेट इज नोन एज डिवाइड बाय टाइम, चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम डिवाइड बाय टाइम। सो फॉर द फर्स्ट बॉडी वी आर टॉकिंग Fk, फर्स्ट बॉडी, व्हाट इज द चेंज ऑफ मोमेंटम फर्स्ट बॉडी के लिए, व्हाट इज द फाइनल मोमेंटम ऑफ फर्स्ट बॉडी, Pa डैश। ओके दिस Pa डैश इज द momentum for final momentum for the first body and Pa is the initial momentum for the first body. So I'm writing here Pa dash minus Pa divided by time is t. So what is P dash A? What is the value we are having? MAVA, here is MAVA minus what is the momentum for the first body of initial, that is initial momentum MAUA divided by time. Up to here I think so that everything is clear to you all. This is the first equation. After that, we can find the value of Fb for the second body, and that is Pb dash, this Pb dash minus Pb divided by P. यही होता है change in momentum by time taken. So what is Pb dash? Value क्या है बेटा? Pb dash की. The Pb dash value is MbVb. So we can write down here MbVb minus MbUv. Divided by time. Consider this is the second equation. When these two bodies interact with each other during collision, they are applying the force on each other in equal and opposite direction. So Newton's third law states to every action there is equal and opposite reaction. So we can write FAB is equal to minus of FP, or we can say F of A is equal to minus of F of B. Yes. Now we can put this first and two equation instead of FA and FB. So in FA we can write on MA VA minus MA UA divided by time is equal to minus sine of MB VB minus MB UB divided by time. Time and time cancel out. This time and time cancel out. Now what do you get? MA VA minus MA UA, take this minus inside, this minus ko andar le jaiye, what you get? MB VB minus minus plus, here you get MB UB. Okay, so now take this MB VB towards this side, V term one side and U term another side, what you get? MA VA, this minus sign, this minus sign, when it moves in the left hand side, it will become plus. MBVB is equal to, what is the next one? Now, you will get this MAUA, when it moves in the right hand side, you will get MAUA plus MBUB. So, can we say that what is the final momentum after collision? This is the final momentum, PA dash plus PB dash. MAVA plus MBVB. So, do we get this MAVA plus MBVB? Yes, we get this. Similarly, on the left hand side, we are having the total momentum before collision, MAUA plus MBVB. So, this is the answer of MAUA plus MBVB. So, we can say that this is total momentum after collision. Is equal to total momentum before collision. I think so. I have made myself clear to you. This law is very, very important, and it always asked in the examination. So please be very careful while doing this equation. That is a law of conservation of momentum. That is. Total momentum before collision is equal to total momentum after collision. So we can solve one of the example for that. So I am clearing all my this drawing. Now what we have to do? We have to do the application of this. That is the we can say recoiling of gun. Next is application is recoiling of gun. This is very important. On the basis of this recoiling of gun, you will always get your numericals. How to solve the numericals, I'm telling you now. So, recoiling of gun. So in recoiling of gun means when the trigger is pressed by the gunman. Okay, the bullet is moving in the outward direction. Okay, so what happened before starting that trigger of the gun? Gun as well as bullet, gun plus bullet remains at rest before starting. Yes or no? So when it starts, the bullet is coming outside. Okay. So now only we have seen the formula that MAVA plus MBVB is equal to MAUA plus MBUB. So we have seen that gun plus bullet is at rest before that. So when it is at rest, so we can say that initial velocity of gun as well as bullet is equal to zero because they are at rest. In the previous section also I have told you about the this. So what we get? We will get MAVA plus MBVB is equal to zero because UA and UB is equal to zero. So from here, can we find out the value of VB? हमें VB की वैल्यू निकालनी है, recoiling velocity of gun निकालनी है. This VB is known as velocity of gun and VA is known as your velocity of your gun, now that bullet. So we can find out MBVB is equal to minus of MAVA, or we can say VB is equal to minus of MAVA divided by that is M. So this is your equation for the recoiling of gun. So please remember this equation for the recoiling of gun. So how to calculate the recoiling velocity of a gun? Always remember the formula, or you can write down another formula in V2 and V1 term. That is minus M1 V1 divided by M2. This is also the formula for the recoiling velocity of the gun. You can say recoiling velocity of gun. You can find out. Okay. So I think that I have made myself clear to you. So we can solve one example for that. The other examples we will do afterward. So your question is that a body of mass 2 kg. The question is a body of mass 2 kg is given to you. Initially moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second. Initially moving with a velocity of the velocity of 10 meter per second, collide with another body of mass 5 kg, mass 5 kg at rest. After collision, velocity of first body become 1 meter per second. Find velocity of second body. Yeah, dekhiye what it is telling. It is telling ki two bodies are there, both are having the masses 2 kg and 5 kg. Okay, so I'm writing here two masses are given to you. First one is 2 kg, second one is 5 kg. Two bodies are given to you. Okay, m1 m2, and they are moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second. Okay, first velocity, initial velocity is given to you 10 meter per second. In the second, it is telling that it is at rest. It means initial velocity of second body is at rest. That is 0 meter per second. At rest, 0 meter per second. Now, after collision, collision ke baad, the velocity of first body become 1 meter per second. Means collision ke baad, jo final velocity thi, wo kitni hogi first body? 1 meter per second. The second body ki humne kya nikalni hai? Velocity nikalni hai. Okay, velocity of second body. So how to calculate it? We're having the formula. Now only we have taken out. Total momentum before collision, that is m1 u1 plus m2 u2, is equal to total momentum after collision, that is m1 v1 plus m2 b2. Okay, now put all the values. What is m1? m1 is 2. What is u1? u1 is 10. m2 is 5. u2 is 0. Is equal to, again m1 is 2. v1 is 1. m2 is 5. v2 is, we don't know. So something multiply 0 is 0. So we get 2 into 10 is 20. Is equal to 2 into 1 is 2 plus 5v2. So from here we can calculate 5v2 is equal to this 2 when it moves in the left hand side. It will minus 20 minus 2. So we get 5v2 is equal to 18, or we can say v2 is equal to 18 by 5. V2 is equal to 18 by 5. Check it out whether any mistake is there. V1 is, 1 is given to you. Yes. M1 is what? M1 is 2 or 5? Make it correct. This M1 is 2. Okay, it is 2 only. Okay, when it is 5, then we are having the same answer. So we can calculate it. 18 divided by 5. 18 divided by 5. 5 3 is 15. 8 minus 5 is 3. 0. 5 6 is 30. So we will get the answer of this V2 is 3.6 meter per second. I hope that I have made myself clear. So in these four type of questions, we will have to see that what is at rest and which formula we will have to apply, how we can apply, what is given to you. So we will have to check all these things. Then we will have to solve the question. Okay, I think that you are getting 3.6 meter per second. That is the V2 answer. Okay, so these type of question I will bring it again also, and please like, subscribe and share our channel so that others will get the chance to learn. So with this, thank you for your patience. Thank you everyone.